Hello everyone, my name is Yogita and I'm here to share the strategy which I followed to clear the AFCET exam. This time I have cleared it with 224 marks, and the very first thing which I want to stress out is that in order to crack any exam, you have to keep your sources limited and then you have to revise them multiple times. So the old saying goes, practice is the key. And this works for me and I hope this will work for you as well. And the second thing is that out of the four sections that which come in AFCET exam, you have to have three sections 100% prepared, and then the fourth section you can give some leverage. So for me, I have chosen English, Maths and Reasoning to be fully prepared with 100% accuracy, and the GK and GS I have prepared 60 to 70%, and I assure you that when you focus on three sections 100% and the one section which you feel you are you have prepared less, or you are not up to that mark in that sections, you can prepare that in 60 to 70%, then it will work. So combining three sections 100% and fourth section 60 to 70%, you will get good marks. Now I'll be covering up the four sections one by one. First, coming to the English section, I personally do not have any problem in English section, as I have my background in English. I am pursuing my master's degree in English literature. But for those who have, I have advice that you have to keep up with your reading skills. Read newspaper, read novels, articles, anything you like. It's not necessary that you read newspaper only, whatever you like, but read it in English medium. So it will help you in closed test passages as well as comprehension passages for better understanding. Now coming to the idiom phrases and one word substitution, you have to learn them. There is no substitute for it. So you can refer to some good book. I have used Ajay K. Singh book, so it helped a lot. I have learned all the idiom phrases and one word substitution from it, and more often they come from it only. So now coming to the section of vocab in the English part. So what I feel is that the power of retention of words is the main problem. So we can't learn all the words in the dictionary. So what I did was go through the previous exams, previous year's papers, and write the synonyms and antonyms which have been asked there, and keep revising them. Once you are confident that you have learn them sufficiently, then you will move to other words, otherwise they will be sufficient for the preparation of the exam. Now coming to the math sections, as I am preparing for other competitive exams also, so I have taken a coaching for it. And the two key points I want to stress here is that first is the understanding of the concepts, and second is the practice. So these are the two key points which will help you crack this math section. And for practice especially, I would suggest you that instead of practicing few questions of topic per day, what you can do is take 10 questions of each topic per day and then practice them. So this will enhance your efficiency. For the reasoning section, what I felt was there was a less practice material for reasoning. So initially I practiced from the previous year's exams, and for more practice material I googled the topics of the reasoning section, and there were some random sites which have PDFs for those topics like analogy, dot rotation, figure embedded, figure series and figure rotation series. So what you can do is you can Google the topics of the reasoning, download those PDFs, take a printout and then practice it. It will help you, because reasoning demands practice while you'll be solving those figure rotation and figure series questions. So GK and GS section, there are two portions covered in it. First one is static and other one is current affairs. What I feel is that current affairs has a less percentage share in AFCET exam than the static portion, and if you are someone who is weak in GK, So what you can do is you prepare the static portion and you will sail through it easily. Then static portion also is divided into certain topics, or rather I would say subjects, which are history, geography, polity and science. So for history there is a set pattern. The questions come from the modern history and you will be asked about the national movements and congress sessions and all of that. Then for the geography, you need to learn the static part, like capital and currencies, rivers, dams, grasslands. Some of these, they will help you in your reasoning section also, because in the analogy part you will get some capitals or countries from that and you need to figure out the odd one out. So this you can't skip, because it will help you both ways, in the reasoning also and in the GK also. Moving forward in the static portion, we have polity also. Polity may not have a very big portion of questions, but definitely there can be one or two questions from the articles and amendments that are there in polity. So we have to learn them so that we cannot skip one or two questions from that portion also. Now for the science part, there are not directly so many questions from the science part, but science static portion will help you in reasoning also, because where you have to find the odd one out, or there was an analogy. So like human diseases, they will be given, like you have been given four diseases, and one of them, three of them are caused by virus and one of them is caused by bacteria. So you'll be asked to find out the odd one out. And if you are if you do not learn those human diseases from the science portion, then you will be not able to attempt that question. Apart from the human diseases in science, you can also cover topics such as name of all species, classification of animal kingdom, minerals and ores, different instruments and their discoverers. For current affairs portion, you may follow any educator on Unacademy. I have followed Prateek Dalal sir on the Unacademy platform, and his lectures on current affairs and notes are quite helpful in my exam. At last, I would like to bring out three main points. First one is, keep your sources limited and revise them multiple times. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, it will be very helpful for you. They will increase your efficiency and confidence as well. Second one, you need to have a practice session every week or every 10 days as you feel like, because it's important to revise what you have done in the last few days. And then third one is, it is for like for before exams, when your exam is coming 10 days before it, you need to revise each and everything which you have learned from past 2 or 3 months, because otherwise it will all be useless if you do not revise it before the exam. Concise preparation and revision is my tool for clearing this exam, and I hope it will be helpful for you too. Thank you.